Hello and welcome to Raj Sabha TV. You're watching Question Hour, a unique show where we get you the latest from the parliamentary proceedings and the questions asked by members from various ministries and departments and replies given henceforth. I am your host, Rajat Kane, joined with my colleague, Kriti Mishra.
Thank you so much, Rajat, and we hope that all our viewers taking good care and are also keeping healthy.
Well, Kriti, talking of the parliamentary proceedings, Question Hour extremely essential where government gets to answer on several public works done by them through various initiatives and schemes. Now, broadly speaking, there are three categories of questions: starred, unstarred, and short notice. Now, starred are the ones where reply is given directly on the floor of the House.
Whereas unstarred questions are those questions of which answers are given in the written format by the government. And in this show, the Question Hour show, we get all the important unstarred questions asked by the members of the upper house in the previous sessions of Rajya Sabha. So, Rajat, let's begin the show.
Well, the first question of this edition of the show that was asked a member, Kamakhya Prasad Tasa from Ministry of Commerce and Industry. The member sought about the details of the measures undertaken by the ministry to support the setting up of industries in the northeastern region.
Well, the government has given an elaborate reply to this question, and the government goes on to say that to promote industrialization in the northeastern states, including Sikkim, and to generate employment in the region, Government of India implemented various schemes from time to time, like Northeast Industrial Policy 1997, Northeast Industrial and Investment Promotion Policy 2007, Transport Subsidy Scheme in 1971, and Freight Subsidy Scheme in the year 2013. After closure of Northeast Industrial and Investment Promotion Scheme 2007, on 31st of March 2017, the government has introduced the Northeast Industrial Development Scheme 2017, which came into force from 1st of April 2017 for a period of 5 years. Now, under this scheme, a single unit can avail overall benefits up to total investment in plant and machinery subject to maximum limit of 200 crore rupees. And the answer also talks about the 7 incentives that are available to eligible industrial units which are located in northeastern states, including Sikkim, under this particular scheme. Now, these include Central Capital Investment Incentive, which is 30% of investment in plant and machinery with an upper limit of 5 crore rupees. Central Interest Incentive, which is 3% of interest on working capital for 5 years. Central Comprehensive Insurance Incentive, which is reimbursement of 100% insurance premium for 5 years. Income tax reimbursement of central share for 5 years. GST reimbursement for central share of CGST and IGST for a period of 5 years. Employment incentive, under which additional 3.67% of the employer's contribution to EPF, in addition to government bearing 8.33% employee pension scheme contribution of the employer in the particular scheme. And also the transport incentive on finished goods movement by railways, which is 20% of cost of transportation, by Inland Waterways Authority, which is 20% of cost of transportation, and by air, 33% of cost transportation by freight for the station, port, airport nearest to the unit of the station, port, airport, or nearest to the destination point. And joining us on the Question Hour show is Rajya Sabha MP, Mr. Kamakhya Prasad Tasa. Sir, welcome to Rajya Sabha Television, and thank you so much for joining us through virtual platform. Sir, आप जानते हैं कि हम क्वेश्चन आवर शो में लगातार उन सवालों को उठाते हैं जो राज्यसभा के सदस्य पूछते हैं सरकार से और जिनका सरकार जवाब देती है. और अगर मैं पिछले सत्र की बात करूं तो आपने पूछा है कि किस तरह से नॉर्थ ईस्ट एरिया में इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट हो रहा है. सरकार ने विस्तार से जवाब भी दिया है. क्या मत है आपका पूरे विषय पर?
नॉर्थ ईस्ट का इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट में गवर्नमेंट ने कुछ इनिशिएटिव लिया, जैसे नॉर्थ ईस्ट का आदमी बहुत सारे बाहर में काम के जाते हैं और प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट, यहाँ पर अगर प्रोडक्शन इंडस्ट्री स्थापित हो तो प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट भी कमेगा इस एरिया पे, एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन भी होगा, बाहर नहीं जाना पड़ेगा और कम्युनिकेशन के लिए जो व्यवस्था है वो व्यवस्था भी ठीक हो जाएगा. जैसे हिंदुस्तान विभाग में यहाँ पर एक इंडस्ट्री स्थापित किया था आजम गुवाहाटी, इट इज आई थिंक 500 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम गुवाहाटी, जहाँ पर हिंदुस्तान विभाग ने एक प्लान लगाया है जो मुंबई से सामान लेके वहां पर पैकिंग करता है, वो एक्चुअली पैकेजिंग यूनिट है. वहां पर बहुत एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन हुआ, वो अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी जी का टाइम पे था. अभी भी बहुत सारे एडवांटेज असम को, असम ने, असम गवर्नमेंट ने किया, उसमें बहुत सारे इंडस्ट्री भी लगाए हैं, मेडिसिनल इंडस्ट्री भी लगाया हुआ है तो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट के मेरा एक आदमी का मेरा क्वेश्चन था क्या सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट व्हाट इज द गोल ऑफ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट। सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने बहुत सारे मुद्दे पे हेल्प भी किया है इंडस्ट्री लगाने के लिए, जो एनवायरमेंट चाहिए वो एनवायरमेंट क्रिएट करके रखा है, और खुद प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑनरेबल नरेंद्र मोदी जी नॉर्थ ईस्ट आके नॉर्थ ईस्ट का जो इंडस्ट्री है ऑर्गेनिक खाबे इसको थोड़ा प्रमोट किया है, जैसे ए फॉर नॉट आसाम फॉर ए फॉर जो अब्दुल लक्ष्मी में आसाम को इंक्लूड किया। तो मेरा सवाल था पहले नॉर्थ ईस्ट इंडस्ट्रियल इन्वेस्टमेंट प्रमोशन पॉलिसी था NIPP, उसको गवर्नमेंट ने अमृता गवर्नमेंट ने उसको खराब कर दिया, क्योंकि यहाँ पर खाली सीमेंट इंडस्ट्री लगाते थे, दूसरा इंडस्ट्री नहीं चलते थे, और साथी भी बहुत साथी थी इधर उधर चला गया। तो अभी गवर्नमेंट का मेरा एक रिक्वेस्ट है क्या इसमें आसाम में इंडस्ट्री लगाने के लिए जो व्यवस्था है उसको थोड़ा आगे बढ़ाए, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट पूरा मदद करे, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट भी इसमें मदद में है,
और क्या क्या सुविधाएं चाहिए ताकि जो इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट और नॉर्थ ईस्ट इन रीजन का वो और ज्यादा हो सके।
मेरा हिसाब से अभी तो पॉलिसी जो एनवायरमेंट क्लियरेंस पॉलिसी ये भी आ गया है, बहुत सारे पॉलिसीज में चेंज भी हुआ है, और डोनर ने भी बहुत काम किया है। तो हम लोग का असम है क्योंकि तो असम और नॉर्थ ईस्ट असम में जब मेन स्टेट है तो पॉपुलेशन इज 3.30 करोड़, तो इसमें बहुत पोटेंशियल भी है, और दूसरा मेघालय में भी है। इसमें गवर्नमेंट ने जो व्यवस्था किया उससे और मेरा हिसाब से सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने उसको और प्रमोट करने के लिए व्यवस्था करना चाहिए। कैसे प्रमोट तो किया हुआ है, स्टेट ऑल स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स आर डूइंग वेल, ऑल आर बीजेपी रूल स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स इन नॉर्थ ईस्ट एंड इंटरेस्टेड टू एस्टैब्लिश इंडस्ट्रीज इन नॉर्थ ईस्ट। तो मेरे को नहीं लगता है क्या ये सवाल मैं उठाया था इसीलिए क्योंकि आदमी सोचता है खाली सब्सिडी का बात ही बोलते हैं, सब्सिडी इज नॉट ए मैटर, एनवायरमेंट इज द मैटर, एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स आर डूइंग द एनवायरमेंट। आसाम में सर्वानंद सोनोवाल, मणिपुर में बीरेन सिंह, त्रिपुरा में एस एस चीफ मिनिस्टर, अरुणाचल, नागालैंड सब में ये नॉर्थ ईस्ट आठों स्टेट में ये काम किया था। सबसे बड़ा कम्युनिकेशन का जो व्यवस्था है ये कम्युनिकेशन इज वेरी पुअर है आसाम। अभी अभी हम लोग का गवर्नमेंट ने रेलवे जो ट्रैक है अरुणाचल रेलवे ट्रैक को इसमें नागालैंड में थोड़ा भी पहुंचा है, वो बहुत हिली स्टेट है। आसाम में तो फायर कम्युनिकेशन इज वेरी गुड बिकॉज फोरलेन है ब्रिज, फायर अरुणाचल का पास ही फोरलेन पहुंच गया है, और ब्रिज जो बन रहा है बहुत ब्रिज ब्रह्मपुत्र का ऊपर में बन रहा है, बराग मेले में बन रहा है, इसमें बाकी स्टेट का भी थोड़ा ध्यान रखना जरूरी है, और स्टेट्स का चीफ मिनिस्टर भी लगा हुआ है। मेरे को लगता है कुछ साल क्योंकि बहुत ही लैंडलॉक था बोलना नहीं चाहिए पार्टी का बात, पहले जो गवर्नमेंट था इसको लैंडलॉक करके रखा था, इसमें कम्युनिकेशन का भी प्रॉब्लम था। कांग्रेस का गवर्नमेंट ने नॉर्थ ईस्ट को तो एक टाइम में बाय बाय कर दिया था, तो अभी इसको महत्वपूर्ण दृष्टि से देखा जा रहा है और हम लोग का प्राइम मिनिस्टर इसमें प्रायोरिटी दे रहा है, इसलिए मेरे को लगता है। और जो सब्सिडी है उसको भी बढ़ाना चाहिए और एनकरेज भी करना चाहिए, दोनों हम लोग का गवर्नमेंट कर रहा है।
जी बिल्कुल कामाख्या जी, आप हमसे जुड़े, आपने हमसे ये सारी बातें विस्तार में की, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद राज्यसभा टीवी से बात करने के लिए। Let's move on to the next question that was asked by the same member, but this question pertains to the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. And the member has asked about the quantity of oil produced by ONGC in Assam.
Well, giving a detailed reply to this query, the ministry said that government offered petroleum mining lease of small and medium size and discovered fields, proven reserves discovered by ONGC and oil to private sector in August 1992 and October 1993. In 1993, the government invited bids under international competitive bidding for the development of various medium and small-sized oil and gas fields in India, including the state of Assam. 28 contracts were signed by Government of India for 29 pre-NELP discovered fields, including one in Assam. A PSC for Amguri field in Assam was signed on 23rd February 2001 for 25 years between Union of India, Assam Company Limited and Joshi Technologies International Incorporation USA. Now, many marginal fields discovered by national oil companies and other private companies could not be developed due to factors such as size of reserves, oil price over project life, development cost, availability of technology, fiscal regimes, and overall risk assessment by the operator. For early monetization of these unmonetized discoveries of national oil companies discovered small fields, policy was launched on 25th May 2016. The 13 contract areas located in state of Assam had been awarded to contractors through two ICB rounds so far carried out by or under DSF policy. Now, out of 13 contract areas, 11 have been awarded to private operators and one to consortium of public sector undertaking and private company and one to PSU and standalone basis. Well, time for a very short break. More on the other side. Keep watching Question Hour.
घटम प्राचीन दक्षिण भारतीय ताल वाद्य जब बजता है तो सृष्टि के पांच तत्वों धरा जल वायु अग्नि और आकाश के स्वर को इसकी धुन में किया जा सकता है महसूस। घटम पर उंगलियों और हथेली के थाप से उत्पन्न हुई स्वर तरंग पैदा करती है अद्भुत ताल।
Welcome back. You're watching Question Hour on Rajya Sabha TV. Now, this question was asked by member K. Soma Prasad from the Ministry of Home Affairs. The member asked whether government has initiated caste-based consensus for scheduled caste and scheduled tribe and OBCs or the other backward classes in the country.
While giving a very specific reply to this question, the government says that the intent for conducting Census 2021 has been notified in the Gazette of India on 28th of March 2019. The census schedule is designed in consultation with various stakeholders. In census, the castes and tribes which are specifically notified as scheduled castes, scheduled tribes as per presidential order under the Constitution Scheduled Castes Order 1950 and Constitution Scheduled Tribes Order 1950 amended from time to time are enumerated. Now let's move on to the next question asked by member KK Ragesh, and this question pertains to the Ministry of Labour and Employment. And the member has asked the government about the targets that it has achieved and also about the investment that has been made in generation of employment and also private and agricultural sector during the last 5 years.
Well, replying to this, the ministry has said that vacancies in central government are caused due to retirement, resignation, death or promotion, and the post falling vacant are required to be filled as per recruitment rules by the concerned ministries, departments and the organizations. Now, filling up of the vacant post is a continuous process depending on the vacancies arising across ministries, departments during the year and action calendar of the recruiting agencies. Now, employment generation coupled with improving employability is a priority concern of the government. Government has taken various steps for generating employment in the country, like encouraging private sector of economy, fast-tracking various projects involving substantial investment and increasing public expenditure on schemes like Prime Minister's Employment Generation Program run by Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprises, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme, Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay Gramin Kaushalya Yojana, that is run by Ministry of Rural Development, and Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana National Urban Livelihood Missions run by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Moving on to next question that was asked by member T.G. Venkatesh from Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. The member asked about steps taken by government to enhance exploration and production of crude oil in the country.
Responding to this query, the government says that it has taken several steps to enhance exploration and production of oil and gas in the country, which include policy for relaxations, extensions and clarifications under production sharing contract, regime for early monetization of hydrocarbon discoveries, discovered small field policy, hydrocarbon exploration and licensing policy, policy for early monetization of coal bed methane, setting up of national data repository, appraisal of unappraised areas in sedimentary basins, reassessment of hydrocarbon resources, policy framework to streamline the working of production sharing contracts in pre-NELP and NELP blocks, policy to promote and incentivize enhanced recovery methods for oil and gas, policy framework for exploration and exploitation of unconventional hydrocarbons under existing production sharing contracts, and also coal bed methane contracts and nomination fees as well. And moving on to the last question of this edition of the Question Hour show, asked by member R. Vethilingam, and this question pertains to the Ministry of Steel. And the member has asked the government whether domestic steel industry has been going through a tough period due to low demand and also falling steel prices.
But replying to the query, the ministry said no. Increase in consumption of total finished steels in India for the last 2 years is presented in the table along with the annexures to the answer. Now, the prices of steel have a downward trend during current year due to overall trend in steel market, but it has shown an increase from October 2019. The price of iron ore depends on market dynamics and is fluctuated from time to time during the year. Now, auto and manufacturing demand is correlated to steel sector. The demand for steel has direct relation to demand in auto sector. Last year, the demand for steel for auto sector has increased due to decrease in demand in automobile sector.
So those were the important questions and answers in this edition of the Question Hour show. Take care and stay safe.
Keep watching Rajya Sabha TV for more national and international top stories.